In the last lesson, we learned how to find the slope of the tangent line at a point using limits. We also called this the derivative, or f prime. Now, we're asked to find f prime of 1, f prime of 2, f prime of 3, and f prime of 4 for the same function, f of x equals x squared. Now, we found f prime of 1 last time, and we could do the exact same thing again to find f prime of 2, 3, and 4. But you must be thinking to yourself, there's got to be a better way to do this. And there is. If we look at the picture and the definition that we looked at last time, where it says the slope of the tangent line at the point A, f of A, is the line through A, f of A with the slope, the limit as h goes to 0, f of A plus h minus f of A over h. Using this formula, we find the slope of the tangent line at one point. But what if we wanted to find the slope of the tangent line at every point on this graph at the same time? We could do this by changing all these a's to x's. So at the point x, f of x, a line through the point x, f of x, with a slope, limit as h goes to 0, f of x plus h minus f of x over h. And what this is going to give us, if we finish out this computation, is f prime of x, which is going to be a formula for the slope of the tangent line at x. So if you plug in a value for x into this f prime of x formula, you will get the slope at that point that you plug in. So for example, if we look back at f of x equals x squared, we previously found f prime of 1 right here. But we could do the exact same computations as we did in this example, but with x's there instead of 1's. So let's try it. The limit as h goes to 0 of f of x plus h minus f of x over h. So since our f of x is x squared, this is going to mean that we're looking at the limit as h goes to 0 of x plus h squared. We replace x in our function with the x plus h in parentheses, minus f of x, which is x squared, all over h. Now, remember that x squared is a polynomial, so we're going to use the same steps as before. We're going to say the limit as h goes to 0, and we're going to expand out the top. So we have x squared plus 2xh plus h squared minus x squared all over h. And notice that x squareds cancel here, just like the 1's did when we were finding f prime of 1. And just like before, we now have an h in every term, so we can factor it out. So the limit as h goes to 0 of h times 2x plus h divided by h. Now we can cancel those h's. And we're taking the limit as h goes to 0 of 2x plus h. So we're letting h become 0. So we're looking at 2x plus 0, which is 2x. So we found f prime of x is 2x. This means that 2x is a formula for the slope of the tangent line of x squared at x. So if we want to know f prime of 1, like we found before, plug 1 into this formula, 2 times 1 gives us 2. That's what we found before, using the long way. But now we can also find f prime of 2, 2 times 2. So if we were to draw a tangent line at 2, we would get a slope of 4. If we were to draw a tangent line at 3, we'd get a slope of 2 times 3, which would be 6. And if we were to draw a tangent line at 4, We would get a slip of 2 times 4, which would be 8.